personally, where I will help is once I'm in the industry and I'm in a position where I can bring people in, you know, especially if I'm working on Black narratives for Black game developers. I mean, that's definitely like a whole new scene that could be developed.
Hey, what's up, you people? It's Johanna, aka Jojo. I'm super excited because we are here today with Caris Taylor. So I met Caris on Clubhouse, and Clubhouse is like this new platform, social media, where you, it's an audio platform media, where you actually network. And I met Caris in a room and I said, no, I need to talk to her for my segment, The Overlooker Jones. I want her to have this voice and to give her this voice. So Caris, with no further ado, you can introduce yourself. Thank you for being here.
Thank you for having me, Johanna. You're doing amazing things, you know, with this platform, and I just continue. I want to see more. So this is great. And thank you for having me. My name's Caris. Some people might know me as K Minor in my music industry, you know, connections. But basically, just to introduce myself, I'm working towards being an audio implementer and creator within games. And my journey very much started from when I was working in music production. I mean, if we're going way back, I mean, I started playing piano before I could reach, you know, I was banging the keys, and that's how it started. I was blessed to have like a really old piano in the house that I lived in with my parents, and just couldn't leave it alone. And my mum just said, right, let's just give her lessons because, you know, it's noise otherwise. And moving on from there, I kind of got into performing. So I did a lot of live performances, met a lot of amazing people, and got to work with some incredible artists who are doing really well now. And off the back of that, decided to go to uni because I wanted to see where my skills in music and audio, recording and production, because that's kind of where I'm coming from. Even though I've done live gigs, I do work on music production. That's kind of my main kind of remit, but I just wanted to find out where I could like expand those skills away from the music industry. And uni was a great kind of entry, you know, into games. My teacher, lecturer, Jamie Stonehouse, who's pretty amazing. Well, he's taught us kind of like the engine Unity, and he's taught us FMod, which,
okay.
Yeah. So we're learning like how to use Unity. And even though it's an audio course, because I'm learning audio engineering and production, still is good to know how to do some of the dev, you know, development end of things within Unity. And I just think the community and the platform is great because it's so easy to use and you don't have to be an avid coder to use it, which is great. So that's basically the introduction. I mean, in my musical life, I've done quite a lot. I've worked with brands such as Red Bull, Saffron, PRS. These are all industry kind of, you know, organizations, but I really wanted to try and move away from the music industry, not just for my personal, you know, reasons. I just felt like I wanted to be able to create in a different way, and I feel like games and films gives me a whole different world of creativity, which I just fell in love with, and I haven't looked back since. And I've just been researching, and we found each other on Clubhouse, but I'm literally on there every trying to find out stories, information on, you know, new developments, even NFT, like within the crypto space, but that's linked to games. It's a very exciting time at the moment, and I'm just really happy to be involved. So
definitely. So thank you. But tell me, what really pushed you to look into gaming? And because you were a gamer, or what?
Yeah. I mean, I was brought up with brothers, so, you know, growing up, I've seen games, you know, from the first generation PlayStation upwards. My dad and my older brother used to build computers in the 90s. Mm-hmm. Without showing my age, of course, like I was a child in the 90s and saw them build computers from scratch. Basically, my brother and dad built computers from scratch, and as a result, My older brother was into gaming. So, you know, I came across like the very old Grand Theft Auto, Bird's Eye View, which is like 2D, you know, and especially some of the younger generations might not know about that game or that version of GTA. But so it kind of started from there. And I always loved gaming. I think gaming is great for so many different levels, mental health, you know, even just escapism, you know. And right now with everything as we know going on, without saying that dreaded C word, we kind of all need a bit of escapism, don't we? So I think games are great, and I've always been a casual gamer. But
yes, that's true. Actually, last year, Q2, I think the World Health Organization say that gaming was good for the health, for mental health. And there are, and you know, there are games that games is now used everywhere, gamification, even in banks, oil and gas, architecture. There is some type of gamification everywhere, and serious gaming as well, for that matter, you know, with this focus on do game for goods. So there is this hashtag. I don't know if you research it, games for good, and you will see there is a lot of games that are being developed for the good of our humanity, you know.
That's amazing. And that's the thing, the technology is, you know, so expansive, we can go anywhere with it. So I think that's great that there's more wellness and mindfulness games. Yeah. And there's these games being created with wellfulness in mind. So they're not necessarily designed for your mental health, but there's aspects of the game that's incorporating like solfeggio frequencies, which are designed to make you feel really calm. And they're, you know, very widely used in sound healing and stuff. So it's really interesting. Yeah, I love it. I think it's a great, great industry and there's so much scope.
Yeah, thank you very much for that. And tell me, so now you say that you're trying to get to break into the industry. What stage are you now and what do you need to go where you want to be?
So the stage I am now is kind of just really honing my skills using the middleware software FMod and Unity in combined. So I'm actually working on my own portfolio game based off Viking Village, which is all over Google, by the way. There's so many different versions because it's kind of like the portfolio entry piece, but I really want mine to stand out. So I'm spending some time trying to work out how can I implement, you know, certain assets in this game and how am I going to implement my audio and what's going to be my narrative. So for me personally, the answer to that is just start, you know, like in terms of download FMOD, download Unity, and just try and see what you can do with those two bits of software, bring them together. And basically I'm in uni, which helps as well. You know, I mean, it costs money. It's not free, of course. But you know, being in uni has given me a really good entry level into how to get into the industry. And it really does start with just trying, like, you know, it doesn't take any more than that. I think even people think that you have to have like ample musical knowledge. You don't, like, you can just use stems, you know, you can take somebody else's songs. That's obviously for educational purposes. This is not for you to release and make money from. You can take other stems and you can implement them in FMOD and you can try it out and see how this works. Some of the best implementers, you know, or some of the implementers within games aren't necessarily composers and couldn't play a note if somebody told them to play D. They'll probably play a different note on the piano, but they still have enough of an understanding in order to make it work. And I think that's the beauty as well. You don't have to be creative, but I think it's good to have some understanding of musical theory, just a little bit, because obviously when you're trying to make game audio link, you don't want to have something off key that's trying to link with something on a different key. You know, you've got to understand these things. So just try one. And yeah, I mean, if you really want to spend the $9,000 a year, which is what I'm spending on university, then do it. You know, I mean, I didn't see the value in university until actually being in university. And I did wait a long time. I worked in the music industry for 10 years and then went into university, you know, my late 20s. So now I'm in university. I'm seeing like all the opportunities I can use my skills with. I wouldn't have seen that before. I wouldn't have known what FMOD or Unity was before going into uni. So definitely studying. If you don't want to go the uni route, you know, you can look online and learn. There's plenty of YouTube clips. There's so many. You can go on Reddit forums and find lots of forums on this kind of thing. And just implement, just try, you know, build your own portfolio of games so you can present that to a company. If you're looking for work, if you're looking for work. So yeah, that's it.
Yes. So now you're still at uni. Are you looking for an internship or are you looking for a company to work at for the moment?
Yeah, well, at the moment, yeah. I mean, I'm literally in the last 6 months of my university qualification. I'm doing my dissertation pretty much. Yeah, I'd say definitely, you know, once my dissertation is complete, I'm looking to, you know, branch my skills and just get the experience. I mean, I'm looking to join global games jams and stuff like that to see where, you know, what people I can meet. And I think it's important to have fun. That's so important.
Exactly.
And me, of course, I'd love to. That's the dream, you know, leave uni and go straight into an amazing company and work an amazing job. If I can get that, I'm not going to turn it down.
I trust that you will. That for, I know that we met, when we've met, You told me about what you were doing, implementation in audio, in games. And in my mind, I was like, wow, that's very niche. So you've been talking a little bit about it the last 5 minutes. Can you exactly, for people that don't know it, explain what you do exactly?
Yeah. Sorry, yeah, that probably would make sense as well, wouldn't it? FMOD is a middleware software. So as we know with music, you listen to it from the start to the end, and that's it. You know, whether you listen to it as an MP3 or on a vinyl or as a tape, you know, which is very old school, by the way. but with music implementation, it's slightly different. So that's kind of like you can have a 5 minute piece, but how music's implemented in games is that there's sections to each level or sections to each, how can I explain it, game variable, so to speak. So for example, if you're in idle mode, you know, you might have a particular piece of music playing in idle mode, but then that music then develops as you go into exploration mode, and that's as your intensity goes up. So it's a way of music being triggered where it's not being played linear, it's non-linear music. So it's literally... I think there's actually a specific term for this. It might need to be researched and I can't remember off the top of my head, but it's vertical orchestration and horizontal resequencing. Mm-hmm. So it's literally like, rather than playing music from left to right, you're like looking at music as layers, and mm-hmm. those layers build depending on where in the game you are. You might hit a trigger point and then the music changes because that's now indicating that the enemy is on you. And now all of a sudden, you know, as the player, that there's an enemy who knows that you exist and they're trying to find you, because that audio cue is so important. Yeah. So it's the way of this audio being played in the game and how the game interacts with the audio for it to change based on its environment and the variables as a character. Everyone's experience is different. So I might go left, and going left in a game might present me with a whole new piece of music, which represents that particular exploration or map or area. Whereas if I go, my friend or somebody else goes right, you know, that could then be a whole new piece of music because that's a different area again. So it just makes the player, it makes it very unique to the player and very immersive as well, because it works organically. Wow. So I hope that makes sense. It is quite a lot to take in.
That makes sense. And I'm sure that if there are some viewers who are from the game industry, and they are, they will know what you're talking about. And yes. and then they will definitely reach out to you. So anyway, what I wanted to say is that your handles will be, your social media handles will be in the description box that down there. Is there anything, for example, that you think can be inspiring for young Black women to get into the gaming industry right now?
I think, yeah, definitely just knowing that they can. I mean, I think for me personally, as a young Black woman myself, I didn't know I had the skills to be able to work in the games industry. I didn't know where to start. I didn't know the framework of how this business operates. So it's just having that knowledge, I think, and also knowing that you're not alone, because, you know, it is tough as a Black woman, being in a company, being the only Black person in the company. It can be very tough. It feels very isolating because you haven't got somebody to interact with who is from your diaspora, you know, and in any environment, I think that applies, not even just games, any environment. So I think even just the visual representation of knowing that, oh, wow, there's a woman who does this, that means it's possible that I can do that. And I think literally representation, what you're doing basically is the work, you know. And personally, where I will help is once I'm in the industry and I'm in a position where I can bring people in, you know, especially if I'm working on Black narratives for Black game developers. I mean, that's definitely like a whole new scene that could be developed. I mean, there's so much scope in this. And, you know, we haven't even begun to touch the surface when it comes to that. So that's how I would like to give back myself personally.
Yes, definitely. You're so right. Being able to have the sisterhood, you know, I started the Overlook Audience really as a series on interviews with the goals of highlighting our experiences in the game industry, provide visibility for Black women in the gaming industry, because you can feel isolated. And sharing those experiences and really brainstorming about the solution to attract and retain people, because, you know, in the gaming industry, after 5 years, you are considered as a veteran. Really? Mm. Why? Because he used to have this, you know, turnover because of the lack of diverse experience and as well over issues that was happening in the gaming industry. So it was very much a miracle before. I'm talking in the past because I really am visualizing now. So it was really an environment that diversity was not included really in the industry. And with the heightened awareness of systemic racism, with a large enterprise and corporate pledging to support the cause and the diversity, equity, inclusion, really, I'm hopeful that this will change and we will be able to have this variety of experience, which will translate actually in the content gaming, as you said.
Yeah, 100%. I think you're spot on, right on the money with that. Yeah, 100%. Mm. And I think also the skills, I think it would be nice to know that there's a place where women like us can get those skills, you know? Yeah. So I think having like maybe not even free workshops, you know, I don't know how this, you know, legally and otherwise go down, but, you know, like having like some sort of, like you say, community of people who can share their expertise, you know, do a video on just the basics of how to use a middleware like FMod or WYs. And that introduction could just be what is needed for somebody to go, right, I'm going to look and I'm going to download that and I'm going to do some more research and see what I can do now. So I definitely think the skill base as well needs to rise within our community. Because obviously without that, they don't, you know, I wouldn't have known I had the skills to work in this industry. So anybody else without the awareness. So yeah. 100%.
Of course. An ecosystem is built from the awareness, the skilling up of people, so education. And then after the incubator, accelerator, and then the corporate, like with jobs or startup. So if we want to really have diversity in the gaming industry, we're looking today at having this diversity from exactly primary, secondary school, definitely.
Yeah, definitely. Or we'll maybe even have college courses that are accessible. I think like the criteria of like all the educational curriculum when it comes to music technology, I haven't obviously been in education apart from uni now. I haven't been in college for maybe 8-9 years. But looking at college, for example, like within music tech, maybe there could be some differences. So like if the course is updated with the times, then I think that makes a big difference. So for example, if I'm learning in college that these things are available, going to uni, I can make much more of a specified decision and say, right, I actually want to just do that. Do you see what I mean? So it's like I'm studying an audio production course, which encompasses everything within audio, not just games, films, music, everything, recording, location recording, mixing, mastering. But I think, you know, now I've done this course, I can see that I'm in into games. But if that was kind of introduced a bit earlier on in the educational kind of, you know, cycle, maybe within college, I think that might have been a good introduction to something like FMod, and working even within films, because I think films and games work very similarly. I think if you can work in film, those skills can definitely be translated to games.
But you know that the tool now, you are talking about Unity earlier, Unity is used in film animation as well. So there is so much opportunities in the gaming industry, and this is the goal and what we're trying to what we're working at doing today. So thank you very much, Carrie. Is there anything that you would like to add today?
Yeah, I mean, just to anybody who wants to get into games, anybody who's interested in getting into audio or even development, just do it. I think, you know, Unity, and you know, I keep talking about Unity because it's so good. I think it really is. It's free to download. You don't have to, there's no upfront costs. So to you can just start, you know, straight away and just learn. I think there's so much available knowledge online. I mean, community as a community is one of the best communities I've come across, and everybody is so willing and forthcoming with information, even technical information like coding. You can probably find a script on a forum somewhere which you can then implement in your game. So just don't be afraid to start, I think, is really my only advice to anybody who wants to get involved. Download FBOD or download WWISE, download Unity, and just start. Have fun and make sure you're enjoying yourself, because that's so important.
And that's it.
Thank you very much for your time, Carice. And
Carice,
I know that you have a podcast. Do you want to plug that in?
Yeah, well, actually, it's not my podcast, but I might as well. It's actually a podcast for a friend of mine called Emma, and she's created a podcast called The Callback Show. Mm-hmm. She's an actress, and she's trying to kind of overcome some hurdles in her career, and it's a really good show for actors, you know, actors all across the globe who just want some insight into how to overcome yourself within the industry. And I think that's something we can all relate to.
Exactly. So that's great. So the link, the social media link as well, and the link for the podcast,
yes,
will be in the description. Yes, definitely. The description box. Thank you for your time, Carice. This is Johanna, aka Jojo. Bye.